Disgraced former Bamban Mayor Alice Guo now facing a qualified human trafficking case. The Justice Department filed the case before the Pasig City Regional Trial Court. This after the Supreme Court ordered the transfer of Guo's cases in connection with illegal pogos to Pasig City and Valenzuela City. Now, aside from Guo, also named as respondents were Huang Zhihyang, Zhang Ruijin, and three others. The Presidential Anti-Organized Crime Commission now looking into reports of a former PNP chief allegedly helping dismissed Mayor Alice Guo flee the country. PAOC spokesperson Winston Casho also says they are investigating the possible involvement of individuals in Guo's escape, including Sual Mayor Liseldo Calugay. The PAOC also looking into the links of other executives to pogos.
We're looking at some private individuals and the mayor of Sual, Pangasinan. Primarily because, as disclosed yesterday during the Senate hearing, there is a municipal wharf in the municipality of Sual, Pangasinan. And we've been looking at that municipal wharf as a possible escape route, escape point of the Guo siblings. Our primary focus now is to be able to ensure that we file all the necessary charges against individuals linked to the Pogo in Bamban and in Porac. Likewise, against all local chief executives and or members of the bureaucracy who have helped facilitate not so much an escape, but facilitate the operations of this Pogo.
Casio also says there is no doubt Alice Guo benefited from the illegal activities of pogos.
She's simply a beneficiary of whatever scams, scam proceeds from all of these activities. She's not, I would say that she is in the middle management. She allowed herself to be used for these criminal activities. I believe that their family is into these particular illegitimate enterprises. And there are still other individuals who have yet to be unmasked in this particular episode.
An update now on the effects of Tropical Depression Jenner, which continues to enhance the southwest monsoon. In central Visayas, a number of landslides were recorded due to the downpour. Annie Perez is on the line. Details on that story. Hi, Annie.
Hi, Stanley. At least two villages were reported to incur landslides since Tuesday afternoon due to intermittent rains in central Visayas brought about by the intensified southwest monsoon. In Barangay Balaas, Argao, huge boulders fell from the road, blocking motorists last night. The youth village chief, Shane Ray Gonzaga, who monitored this, said that they were able to notice the landslide when the soil was moving last night. No one was reported hurt from the incident, and the road is now being cordoned off. Those who intend to go to Manlapay or Linutod of the same town must now look for alternative routes. Meanwhile, in Apuhagan, Valencia, Negros Oriental, a landslide was also logged following nonstop rains. The local government unit and private stakeholders joined in clearing the debris that also blocked the roads. Motorists were also advised to detour while clearing operations are ongoing. Several local government units in the province also declared the suspension of classes for today, Wednesday, September 18. And these are Gihulnan City, Ba'i City, Manhuyud, Vallehermoso, Zamboangita, Amlan, and Tanhay City. Others have resorted to shift their modality for classes today from face-to-face to online and to do other activities while intermittent rains and inclement weather conditions are persisting. Even if weather conditions in some parts of the region are already getting better, all local disaster risk reduction and management office in Central Visayas continue to still be on alert. And that's the latest here from Central Visayas. Annie Perez, ABS-CBN News.
All right. Thank you so much for the update, Annie Perez. Children at a nursery in Dubai just got a high-tech playmate. Now, kids at the friendly early childhood center greeted by a robotic dog as part of an innovative approach to early education. The robotic dog is equipped with AI to help nurture young minds. The nursery says it sees AI as something that enhances a child's creativity to go out of the box. This does not come cheap, though, as it cost the nursery some $21,700, or that's around 1.2 million pesos per year.
Our center goes beyond the traditional basics. We blended the classical education with artificial intelligence and high-tech technologies by implementing the interactive tools such as interactive sand table, such as smart tables, robotic dogs that we have at our reception that greet and meet children with their parents at the entry. We believe that and artificial intelligence is not a base to learn and to give a knowledge, but it enhances the creativity and mind of a child to go out of the box and implement that knowledge in a wider world.